that Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow. But I'll be hood forever. I'm the new Sinatra. And since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they love me everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem. All of my Dominicanos right there up on Broadway. Pulled me back to that McDonald's. Took it to my stash.
So one of the themes this month is bound. So it's about you know, kind of like a hostage situation, or you know, someone being apprehended. So here I kind of wanted to do a picture with some thugs, some clown thugs. So here I have a female hostage. So with a very simple cut out where she says, please don't hurt me, and then a bunch of thugs keeping an eye on her. And then I thought I'll do an interesting take where, you know, I have the Bruce Wayne being caught by the Joker, and with Harley Quinn and another clown thug, you know, beside the Joker. So yeah, I just added some props. So maybe I'll just give a tip. So, you know, I intentionally placed the wooden boxes as markers to kind of indicate where the ends of the display are. So you can see I have the rest of my room. So those are kind of markers for me. But then here I have a clown stuck beside the wooden boxes, but it just gives me a rough gauge where I wanted the video to end. And then I have a safe, and then a fridge, and some electrical boxes. So just some you know, props I threw into the display. So you know, this dial is something that Mark G. Nolan made for me previously, so I've shown it a few times. So yeah, that's pretty much my display. So kind of like a thug filming the Joker talking to, I guess, like maybe the Commissioner Gordon, or the mayor, or you know, maybe to Alfred or whoever, asking for a ransom. So yeah, that's my display. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the display, and continue watching M.A.T.O. Not sure why, but decided to do another Bruce Banner picture. So here I have the Egon Spengler figure doubling as Bruce Banner, and I have the Faith figure as Betty Ross, and I just have the Grey Hulk and the Green Hulk kind of staring at them. So let me kind of focus on the figures. Yeah, so yeah, just a vanilla pose. But I think the main thing was I wanted to capture the emotion of their embrace. So I think that's the main thing I wanted to try to convey in this picture. Yeah, so I have a B-side plan, so stay tuned for that. So here is my B-side. I have the Red Hulks. So the Red She-Hulk and the Red Hulk. So of course in front, you have Betty Ross and her father, General Ross. So I thought this would be a nice contrast to the A-side, which was Banner and Betty. So I hope you guys like the pic. Like the pictures, simple concept, but I hope that the emotions comes across in the pictures that I took. So enjoy the pictures, and continue watching M.A.T.O. So today was a very eventful day. What happened was I received a parcel from Jeremy Lee. So the dude did me a really big favor. He got me a bunch of figs at cost price. So here I have the movie Black Widow and the movie Winter Soldier, as well as the Spider-Girl. So he hooked me up with this bunch of figs. Hope Summers was from another buddy who went to the Hasbro warehouse sale locally. So he got me this figure really cheap. It was like something like $5 USD. And I'm just setting up a bunch of displays. So I'm doing an A side and a B side featuring the Winter Soldier and Black Widow. So here I have the comic book versions. And then here I have the movie versions. So I'm gonna just do a simple display featuring both sets of figures. And then just a cutout there. So as you can see, you know, it says they are killers. Pure and simple, believed to be the best in the world. So just a very simple display I set up. So just a quick figure comparison. So these two are comic book accurate, but articulation wise pales in comparison with the movie version, which is pretty surprising, because you know sometimes I tend to avoid movie figures, but I think Hasbro has done a pretty good job with the movie figures. The articulation, the sculpt, pretty dope. Minor gripes, I kind of find that the movie Black Widow feet are kind of too small. Makes it very hard to pose. This version, the comic book version, has a much more decent feet, making her easier to pose. But otherwise, I much prefer the movie Widow. But having said that, the movie Widow kind of has certain issues, so I kind of hate the holsters. I don't know why they couldn't do proper holsters with the removable guns, you know. That's just Hasbro for you, screwing up certain stuff. And the Winter Soldier is pretty dope, but I'm not digging the waist pouches and whatnot. So I don't know. I guess I have to figure something out. So yep, this is kind of my A side. So I'm gonna do a B side in a moment, so stay tuned for that. Yeah, anyways, as promised, I was kind of mucking around with the movie versions of the Black Widow and Winter Soldier. So this is kind of what I came up with. So I have them fighting. So I have Black Widow trying to stab Winter Soldier with a dagger, and he's blocking with his mechanical arm. So I think this is quite cool. So let's see how it turns out on my computer. I'm gonna download the pictures now. Yeah, funny story. So I actually had an Instagram friend ask a question about Ra's al Ghul. So one thing led to another. You know, I was thinking about his League of Assassins, and I ended up thinking about the hand. So yeah, I decided to do the hand picture. So here is my A side with Elektra. So here, you know, I think she kind of stabbed one of her hand ninjas, and then there are two of them taking away the dead body. So this is kind of my A side, and I'm going to do a B side in a moment, so stay tuned for that. Yeah, so I switched things up. So earlier I had the Elektra figure. So now I have Matt Murdock instead. So I don't have a Shadowland Daredevil. You know, that figure has never been made yet. So, you know, I was hoping a buddy of mine, yeah, I'm not gonna mention him, but he's a very famous customizer. So I'm hoping he's gonna make me a Shadowland Daredevil. So yeah, I took a bunch of pics. So let's see how the picture turns out. I hope it comes out well. You know, I think if most of you follow me, you probably know by now that Daredevil is my favorite, you know, Marvel character, especially a hero. So let's see how the pics turn out. Haven't really been buying new figs recently, but I thought I wanted to kind of, you know, it was great growing up in the 80s and the 90s. You know, you had all the amazing creativity, movies, classics, you know, the Star Wars trilogy, Back to the Future, Ghostbusters, Terminator, Robocop. You had all these amazing movies, and then now you kind of have studios running out of ideas. So anyway, I'm kind of digressing. So, you know, I chanced upon this Minimates Ghostbusters set. So, you know, Ghostbusters was one of my favorite movies of all time. And then, you know, who could forget the catchy Ghostbusters theme song. So anyways, I thought I wanted to get this set. So here I'm doing a very simple picture. I have the four dudes, the four Ghostbusters dudes. And I thought I'd just use this figure. You know, I can't remember, it's from Bioshock. Yeah. So anyways, yeah, I thought I'd just quickly put together this display, which is pretty dope. So I have Gwen Spagler, the recently deceased, the character played by the recently deceased actor director. So I thought I'd have him in the foreground, kind of handling the gauge, and then he's beeping away, but not realizing that there's a ghost in the background, and the rest of the dudes panicking. So I thought it was something funny, but yet fun at the same time. So I hope you guys enjoy the pic. So yeah, yesterday was my off day, so I decided to catch the Amazing Spider-Man 2. Very good movie. Definitely worth watching. In fact, I was pleasantly surprised because I thought it was much better than the first Spider-Man movie. Yeah, anyways, this I would guess that this video is relatively spoiler-free. Other than saying that it's a good movie, I'm not gonna say any much else more about the movie. Yep, so anyways, of course Spidey is in the movie, so I don't have any figures from the current wave. So this is actually the Sinister Six Spidey. Can't really recall. Anyways, but I'm using the backpack that came with the Andrew Garfield Spidey for this scene. And yeah, this setup seems simple enough, but surprisingly it was quite painful to do, you know, for different reasons. One, getting the Spidey to balance on the balcony prop, and then you know, I have no freaking idea why, but I originally planned to use the Buffy figure with this display. But I spent hours looking for the Buffy figure, and for whatever reason she's missing. Have no idea where the figure went. So I had to resort to using the Kirsten Dunst Mary Jane figure. And I swapped out the head with the Emma Frost figure. So here I have Gwen Stacy. Oops, and then there it goes. Just as I was talking about the balancing, the Spidey falls off. So anyways, I'm done with this scene. terribly difficult to do, even though it looks simple, but I hope you guys enjoy the picture. So, anyway, I thought that since I had spent so much time on the A side, I thought I'd do a B side with a change. So here, you know, no surprise, Gwen Stacy did die in the comics. So I thought I'd do a scene where, I'll try to replicate this scene. So here I have Spidey kind of mourning the death of Stacy, Gwen Stacy. So I don't know, maybe I'll do some minor tweaks with the adjustment of the body and the the miscellaneous poses. So stay tuned for that.